Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. It means so much. On my channel, I've been doing several different mini makeovers where I help people make over closet spaces in their home on a budget. My hope is to encourage all of you out there that in order to get a clean and neatly organized closet space, you don't have to spend hundreds of dollars, and I will link the videos that I have made for this mini series in the description box below for you as well. So go check those out after you watch this one. But without further ado, let's just get right into today's video. Today's video, I'm going to be making over three closet spaces in my friend's house. She has three closets in her hallway, and we're going to be tackling all of them. The first closet space is housing overflow items from her kitchen. So what we're going to want to do first is empty the closet out completely. And then once everything is emptied out, you're going to want to wipe down the shelves, wipe down the walls, and go ahead and vacuum. I started off first by housing all of her bigger items on the top shelves. And then on the floor, I went ahead and I used the roasting pan insert to divide her lids and trays on, since you don't use your roasting pan all the time. And then I just put a few miscellaneous items on the carpet next to that as well. A lot of her items I kind of just housed neatly back onto the shelves, and then I used a few bins that I purchased from the dollar store and Target to house some of her other items in. I spent $35 on organizing bins for all three closets. I have already organized this friend's master bedroom closet space, and I will link that video down below for you. And basically what I told her is for her color palette for her home, we're gonna wanna be using wicker baskets, white storage bins, and clear or glass containers. Choosing a universal color palette like this is so smart when you go to organize the spaces in your home, because that way you don't feel like you have to buy everything all at once. You can add organizing bins to your closet spaces slowly because those colors are easily accessible in any store. Now we are ready to move on to our second hallway closet, which is kind of a catch-all closet. I feel like she uses this for several different things like toys, tools, arts and crafts, all of those fun miscellaneous items that you have in your home after having children. One of my goals during this mini series that I'm putting together is to encourage moms. As a mom, you only have so many hours throughout the day to get things done, and my hope is to give you attainable goals throughout the week so you can slowly see things getting done around your home. Don't feel like you have to do everything all at once. What I would recommend is to pick one closet space, one drawer, one area of your home that you want to clear out, declutter, deep clean, and reorganize, and give yourself a whole week to do it. Allow yourself 1 to 2 hours every day to work on that one space, and you'll be surprised at how much you're able to get done. When we go in to organize a space and we feel like we have to get it all done in one day, we're often disappointed by the results, because we did things half-heartedly and we weren't able to finish in a way that meets our standards. So give yourself time and don't feel like you have to do everything all at once. I tackled this closet the same way I did the one you just saw, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail on this one, but obviously she does need a little bit more organization in this closet, and she's going to just add that in slowly. Since I was working with a smaller budget, I didn't want to use the bulk of the organizing bins in this closet. I wanted to use it in the first closet you saw, but at least now everything is a lot more organized, and I ended up just using Ziploc bags that she already had on hand to divide things, but hopefully in the future she'll be able to get organizing bins to kind of house things in instead of baggies. But for now, this is what we did, and this is what you can do too. And then every month, just buy a few new organizing containers to add to your closet space. And I will also link one of my favorite label makers down below, because when you're able to label things, it makes it that much more organized. For her last and final closet space, we are going to be tackling her linens. She has all of her bath towels and bedding in this closet. I'm not going to be using any organizing bins in this space because I feel like with the linen closet, as long as you have everything folded neatly, that looks aesthetically pleasing enough. And then later on, if you want to buy baskets, you can, but for now we're going to just empty everything out, as you can see here. And I emptied everything out into sections, and so I'm going to show you with each section how I fold my linens. First, we're going to start with a blanket, and this is just a really pretty quilt that she had. And basically what I do is I fold it in half and then in half again, and I'm going to flip it over here so you can see. I smooth it out and then I fold one end in, and then I fold the other end in, butting them up to each other, and then I fold it again, and it just creates a really nice look. Now I'm going to do this with the rest of the blankets. Now we are ready to move on to the bath towels. I pretty much fold these the same way that I fold the blankets. And I will link my laundry video down below for you. In that video, I talk to you all about how I do the laundry, and I give you a bunch of great tips, one of them being how to make your towels smell good. So make sure you watch that after this. And now I'm going to work on the bed sheets, which the fitted sheets can be quite difficult. So what I like to do for that is just fold it in half twice and then fold the ends in a couple of times as you see me doing here. It's never going to be perfect because fitted sheets seem almost impossible to make look perfect, but this is what I do in my home and I like the results. And then for just the regular sheets that go over the fitted sheets, I fold these in the same way that I fold the towels and the blankets. But I inserted a little video here to show you, just to give you something to look at. And then for the pillowcases, I basically fold them in half as you see me doing here. I smooth it out and then I fold it in half again, and then I fold in the ends and fold it together as you see me doing here, pretty much the same way I do the blankets. It's not a game, it's a ranch thing. And for the beach towels, I'm going to go ahead and fold those the same way I folded the regular towels. And then we're going to just go ahead and fold the dish towels. So basically what I do for these is smooth them out. I fold them in twice, as you see me doing here, and then I fold them in the same way I do the pillows, and that's it. And then I just placed everything neatly back into the linen closet. And that is it. I hope this video encouraged you. I hope it inspired you. Please let me know what you think in the comment section below. And if you are new here, please hit that subscribe button. It seriously means so much to me. And until next time, I love you guys so much. Bye.